Good morning, students. Myself Rashmi Yande, your science teacher. Stay home, stay safe, learn well. Today we are going to start our next part of our lesson,
Darwin's theory of natural selection. The scientist Charles Darwin, he collected innumerable specimens of plants and animals, and depending upon the observation of those specimens, he published the theory of natural selection, which preaches the survival of fittest. For this purpose, Darwin had published a book titled Origin of Species. This explaining the concept that all organisms produce prolifically. That means proper reproduction is occur. All the organisms compete with each other in a life-threatening manner. There is a competition is occur in between these animals to sustain in environment. In this competition, only those organisms sustain, that is the continues, which shows the modifications essential for winning the competition. However, besides this, natural selection also plays important role, because nature selects only those organisms which are fit to live and the rest perish. Two theories are there in the origin of species, that is the natural selection and survival of the fittest. These two concepts are there, but they are interlinked with each other. As we know that there is a competition is occur to sustain their life, to continue their life. Yes, and during this competition, each and every animal, they try to modify as per the environmental condition. Sustaining and selected organisms can perform reproduction and thereby give rise to the new species with their own specific characters. This is nothing but the natural selection and survival of the fittest. Darwin's theory of natural selection was widely accepted for long duration, but certain objections are there. First one, natural selection is not only factor responsible for evolution. Darwin's did not mention any explanation about useful and useless modifications. There is no explanation about slow changes and abrupt changes. So these are the limitations for this theory. These things are not properly explained by the Darwin's theory. Therefore, next theory it is, that is the Lamarckism. The next theory is Lamarckism. Jean-Baptiste Lamarck, this scientist, proposed a theory in which he stated that morphological changes occurring in living organisms are responsible for evolution, and the reason behind those morphological changes is activities or laziness of that organism. He called this concept as principle of use or disuse of organs. Here, if you observe, the neck of giraffe has become too long due to the browsing on leaves of tall plants by extending their neck for several generations, not in one generation. Initially, maybe the length of the neck of that giraffe is very less, but as there is a change into the environment, tall plants, number of tall plants, they grow, and for browsing purpose they trying to catch that leaves. At this situation, there is a extension of their neck area is occurs. That means they use this organ to fulfill their requirement. Yes. Similarly, the shoulders of the iron smith have become very strong due to the frequent hammering movements. In these both examples, that is iron smith, that giraffe, they use their organ for evolution purpose. Due to the changes in that, evolution is occur, changes are occur. Now, next two examples. Wings of birds like ostrich and emu have become weak due to no use. And these birds cannot fly at high height. Why? Because their wings become weak due to the no use of that organ. Legs of the birds like swan and duck have become useful for swimming due to living in water, and snakes have lost their legs by modification in their body for burrowing habit. One type of characters are natural characters, genetic characters, which are as it is from parents. And another type of the characters are acquired characters, and are transferred from one generation to another generation. This is called the theory of inheritance of acquired characters or Lamarckism. Inheritance, that is, whatever the acquired character in that generation, it get transferred, it get inherited into the next generation, and like it, generation to generation. This theory is the Lamarckism. Development of organs due to specific activities or their degeneration due to no use at all was widely accepted, but transfer of those characters from generation to generation was rejected. In Lamarckism, two parts are there. Due to specific activities, there is a degeneration, or there is a properly development of that organ is there. This concept is accepted. But second part, which is the part of that, generation to generation these characters are transferred, it was rejected. Why? Because it has been verified many times that modifications brought in us are not transferred to the next generation, and thereby Lamarck's theory was disproved. The living organisms can transfer the characters which it has acquired to next generation. This is called ancestry of acquired characters. Now, the next part, it is the speciation. Speciation, that is nothing but the formation of new species of plants and animals. Splitting, or we can say the variety or form, that is nothing but the speciation. And all these new species of plants and animals, it is nothing but the effect of evolution. Yes, the species is the group of organism that can produce fertile individuals through the natural reproduction. Through the reproduction process, they can continue their species, but according to the geographical conditions, their food, habitat, reproductive ability and period is different. For example, suppose dog, it is a species, yes, but in that there is a variety of dogs are present. Domestic dogs are different one. Yes. So that means this is the speciation. This is the speciation. Why it occurs? The difference into the geographical conditions. Polar region dog is also dog, and domestic dog is also dog. But there is a difference in between their food, their habitat, their reproductive ability and reproductive period is also different one. Domestic cat or any example we can take. Species are same, but there is also a variety we can observe. This is nothing but the speciation. Because when there is a geographical conditions are changed, automatically we have to match up our body with that geographical condition, and certain changes, which are nothing but the variations, are occur inside our body. After that, the last part of our lesson, it is the human evolution. How humans are evolved from lemur to wise man, that is the Homo sapien. Up to that, a huge journey is there in this human evolution. This takes time of the 7 crore years. To develop from lemur to the wise man.
Ancient animals like lemur, from that there is a development of ape-like animal. After that, Egyptopithecus, Dryopithecus, Ramapithecus, Australopithecus, skilled human, man with erect posture, Neanderthal man, Cro-Magnon man, and after that wise man, that is the Homo sapiens. This journey is there, this type of development is occurred. when last dinosaurs disappeared approximately 7 crore years ago. At that time, monkey-like animals are said to be evolved from some ancestors who were more or less similar to the modern lemurs. And tale of these monkeys-like animals of Africa is said to be disappeared about 4 crore years ago. Disappeared, that means there is a development of occur. How? The development due to the enlargement in brain, their hands were also improved and thus ape-like animals were evolved. Those apes started to live on land. After that, as there is a decline into the environment, decline into the forest due to the dry environment, there is a changes are occur. Which changes? Their pelvic girdle. Their pelvic girdle. Here, instead of lumbar bones, you have to write down pelvic girdle. They started to stand in erect posture in grassland, and thereby their hands became available for use anytime. They properly use their hand for eating purpose, because this time they can only walk on the two legs. There is no use of these hands for walking purpose due to the erect posture, development of this posture. So this happened about 2 crore years ago. First record of human-like animal is with us in the form of Ramapithecus. Ramapithecus, that is nothing but about 1 crore year ago. The Ramapithecus, it is the first human-like animal is there from India and East Africa. From India and East Africa. Afterwards, this ape grown up in size and became more intelligent, and thus the ape of South Africa evolved about 40 lakh years ago. In this way, gradual development is occur and which leads to the evolution. Here, if you observe the development of the human brain, now whatever the special characteristics which is present in human being apart from other animal, it is nothing but the brain, developed, well developed brain. Yes, so the morphology of these human like animals started to appear like to be the member of genus Homo about 20 lakh years ago, and the skilled human developed about 15 lakh years ago. Human walking with erect posture was evolved. It may have existed in China and Indonesia of Asian continent. In this way, after the erect posture, there is a development of bodies occur. Their brain is also developing, and due to the slowly development, the wise man evolved or developed. Yes, evolution of upright man continued in the direction of developing its brain for the period of about 1 lakh years, and meanwhile it discovered the fire. You know, you studied in history also, that is, there is a invention of the fire. After that, before the invention of the fire, we eat the raw food, that means that animals eat the raw food. Yes, but after the invention of fire, cooking is started, and proper they cook the food. And brain of 50,000 years old man had been sufficiently evolved to the extent that it could be considered as the member of class wise man, that is the Homo sapiens. So in this way there is a proper journey, there is a proper development is occur. Neanderthal man, it is a first example of the wise man. Why? Because there is a proper erect posture is there, proper considered as the first member of the wise man. About 10,000 years ago, wise man started to practice the agriculture. It started to rear the cattle, establish the cities, cultural development took place. Art of writing was invented about 5,000 years ago, and thus the history had been started. Modern sciences emerged about 400 years ago, and industrial society was established about 200 years ago. And now we have reached at this stage,
and still we are searching the details of roots of the human ancestry. Now your first lesson is over. First of all, you have to read this lesson properly, and whatever your doubts, mark it and you can ask me. You can solve the complete exercise in your notebook. Each and every question you have to solve. Thank you.